hyper conjugation. Right down. It is also known as sigma pi resonance or no bond resonance. Sigma pi resonance or no bond resonance. It is possible in the case of carbocation or in case of free radical. Carbonyl does not show hyperconjugation. Okay, carbonyl does not show hyperconjugation. Okay.
So is that no bond resonance?
Yeah.
How can you have resonance with no bond?
I'll explain that. Okay. So you see the example here. Suppose we have an alkene, CH3CH, double bond CH2. Okay. This molecule. Now you see this is the alpha carbon. Alpha with respect to this functional group, right? This is double bond. We can also consider this as a functional group. The adjacent carbon of this carbon is the alpha carbon, we can say, right? Now this alpha carbon is what? sp3 hybridized, and it has 3 alpha hydrogen. Yes or no? Number of hydrogen attached at alpha carbon is known as alpha hydrogen. So how many alpha hydrogen we have here? 3. So hyperconjugation depends upon the number of alpha hydrogen. More number of alpha hydrogen, more hyperconjugating structure you can draw, right? So this molecule, you see, we can write this molecule as carbon hydrogen. CH2. Hyperconjugative structure, if you have to draw, this sigma bond comes over here and this pi electron shift onto this carbon. Right? And the structure we get here is HC. Here we have H plus. CH double bond, sorry, single bond CH2 negative charge. Okay.
So H plus will go away.
No, H plus going to
that. It's not bonded.
That's why it is no bond resonance.
So it can become that again.
Yes. So fine.
What is the alpha thing?
I'll explain. Let me finish this first. Okay. Let me finish this. Okay. So this sigma bond comes over here, pi bond shift over here, but this H plus will not go away. It will be there only, near this carbon atom. This means what? Either this sigma bond can come over here, this also can come over here, or this also can come over here. All these three exchange will be there. This comes, and then this comes, so all these sigma bond converts into pi, and then again into sigma, okay? So this can go into this way, and this can also come over here, and this pi sigma bond goes over here, again you will get the structure.
So you see that all of them are different structures.
What? Yes, yes, yes. So another structure of this, if you draw, that would be CH, H, all these three structures possible.
So why does it do that? Why does it do that?
See, because of this carbon is slightly more electronegative than this. This drags the sigma bond towards its sides. Kind of minus I effect. Okay. That's why this continuous shifting is there. Of sigma into pi, sigma into pi, sigma into pi. So all these structures are called hyperconjugative structure. Consider here the number of hyperconjugative structure you are drawing. These three structures are possible here because of 3 alpha hydrogen. What is alpha hydrogen? Alpha hydrogen is the hydrogen atom hydrogen attached with? Attached with alpha carbon. Okay, alpha carbon is the carbon, is the adjacent carbon of any functional group. Like this is the carbon attached with double bond. So this carbon is the alpha carbon, and all these hydrogen are the alpha hydrogen. Right. So number of hyperconjugative structure is equals to the number of alpha hydrogen plus 1. This structure also becomes. Number of alpha hydrogen plus 1.
Sir, how is the electronegativity of the red carbon and that carbon more?
What?
The electronegative resistance.
This carbon is sp2 hybridized. This is sp3 hybridized. So mode percentage as corrector. Okay. Okay. So since this is, you see first here, the sigma bond converts into pi here. Sigma converts into pi, that's why it is sigma pi resonance. Delocalization of electron, that's why it is resonance. Okay. No bond resonance, why? Because H plus present over here without any bond. Okay, that's why it is no bond resonance.
In this case,
we have 3 alpha hydrogen plus 1. Yeah, 3 alpha hydrogen plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4 is structure.
So, what causes the hydrogen from not just?
Because this is not that strong actually. This effect is not that strong. Okay? So, and all these sigma electrons has equal tendency to form a pi bond. Right, sometimes this will form and again it comes back, this forms, comes back, this forms. So it keeps on exchanging.
How do you identify the alpha carbon?
Alpha carbon is this one.
The one that's sp3.
See, the one alpha carbon is the carbon which is the adjacent carbon of the functional group. Okay, so this carbon is the alpha carbon here. This carbon with double bond, this carbon is the alpha carbon. Adjacent carbon just here. Like suppose this example, if you draw, right? So how many alpha carbon hydrogen are there? We have CH3 here, CH3 here, 3 hydrogen here, 3 hydrogen here, 6 alpha hydrogen. 6 alpha hydrogen plus 1 given structure. Total hyperconjugating structure will be 7, but the number of alpha hydrogen is 6. Okay. No, this won't take alpha one. Adjacent of this. Adjacent of this. Calculate the number of alpha hydrogen. Number of alpha hydrogen.
What's the alpha? Do you know that the genus called alpha?
Number of alpha hydrogen. Okay, so what we were discussing? Hyperconjugation. Number of alpha hydrogen, tell me in all these molecules.
First one, it's 12 alpha.
12?
Yes.
How many alpha carbon we have here?
4.
All these carbons are alpha carbon. Adjacent carbon we have to see. Right? 4 alpha carbon, and each carbon has 3 hydrogen, right? So we have 12 alpha hydrogen here. Alpha hydrogen. This is the alpha carbon?
No, it's 8.
Alpha carbon? This is the alpha carbon? Alpha carbon and alpha carbon. And each of these carbon has 2 hydrogen. So number of alpha hydrogen is 8. How many alpha hydrogen we have here?
Why do you cover those?
This one? Alpha hydrogen, sorry, alpha carbon. Say alpha carbon, alpha carbon, alpha carbon. So it is 10. Alpha hydrogen here. This is the alpha carbon. This is the alpha carbon. For this one, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4 plus 2, 6. 1, 2, 4, 6. It's very simple. Why alpha hydrogen is important to count? Because the stability of alkene depends upon alpha hydrogen. Okay. See, the application part of it, the more number of hyperconjugative structure you can draw, more will be the stability of alkene. Correct? So, and we know that number of hyperconjugative structure depends upon what? The number of alpha hydrogen. So when the molecule is given, stability you have to compare. Just you count number of alpha hydrogen, and if alpha hydrogen is more, stability of alkene will be more. Correct? So next one you write down, stability of alkene. Alkene, double bond. Hyperconjugation is possible in alkene, no? Alkene, carbocation and free radical, right? So stability of alkene, write down, the stability is directly proportional to the number of hyperconjugative structure, the number of hyperconjugative structure, which is nothing but the number of alpha hydrogen. Okay, now you compare the stability of these molecules. A,
so what happens if you have equal number of?
We'll take them. The same logic we have for resonance. See, more number of structure means what? More distribution of electron. More distribution of electron means more stability. Right? And that is the same logic we have for resonance also. Two structures are given, and if you compare the stability, if the number of resonating structure is more, stability will be more. Because more uniform the distribution of electron is. First one, tell me.
ABC. The highest
number of alpha hydrogen here?
It's 12.
Here?
9.
3, right? More alpha hydrogen, more hyperconjugative structure, more will be the stability. So decreasing order of stability will be this. Okay? In this one, number of alpha hydrogen?
8.
Number of alpha hydrogen here is 8. 3. This one is more stiff. Here?
It's
3.
2.
And 1 plus 1.
7.
3.
Yeah. I have it.
Correct. 3 plus 2 plus 2. 7.
1.
7.
Only this carbon, right?
It's 1.
Oh, wait, sir, does that not have any alpha carbon?
Well,
benzene,
yes, we do not have any alpha carbon here. So in this case, hyperconjugation is not the case because alpha hydrogen is not present.
But it does have two resonating carbons.
No, in this you see, this double bond if you consider. Here we have one hydrogen, but that is not sp3 hybridized, it's sp2. So we have sp3 hybridized alpha
carbon.
Wait. So here we do not have hyperconjugation possible. Even here also hyperconjugation is not possible. But this compound is aromatic, this one is anti-aromatic. So which one is more stable?
Sir, it's because we took the chain and that's...
Yes, it is. See, in all these compounds, hyperconjugation are possible. Because we have sp3 hybridized alpha hydrogen, but here we do not have. But this one is aromatic, anti-aromatic is stability.
So how is that anti-aromatic?
What this thing is, how many pi electrons?
Yeah.
4 pi. The aromaticity and anti-aromatic is only defined for cyclic compound, cyclic conjugated compound. Side chain we won't consider. Okay. What about this one?
Sir, is that 7?
Do we have alpha hydrogen here?
Yeah.
Yes.
How many?
Is it 7?
3. Sorry, 2 plus 2, 4. And here it is.
So you don't count the CH3 one?
No, we have own. This.
No. So, 7 is
7.
It should
be 7.
Yeah.
So isn't that old?
No, this. For this L double bond, this is alpha carbon. This is alpha carbon. That is it.
So that carbon is not alpha?
No, it's not. The adjacent atom is oxygen, not CH3. We are comparing the stability of alkene with respect to this. We are doing.
So you can't count any other option.
No. Hyperconjugation, if you are considering, then alkene shows hyperconjugation. So with respect to this one, alpha hydrogen is 4, alpha hydrogen here is what? C plus 2 plus 2. Which one is more stable? Which one is more stable here?
The second one.
But the answer is this.
Why?
Hyperconjugation is fine, but here we have resonance. This alkene is stabilized through resonance. Right? So the stability of alkene, the order is this. I effect is least. Then we have hyperconjugation and then resonance. So if the alkene is getting stabilized by resonance, that will be the more stable alkene.
So hyperconjugation is?
Hyperconjugation, if you consider only, then this one is more stable. Because we have here hyperconjugation possible, resonance is not possible. Here we have hyperconjugation as well as resonance. Pi, sigma, lone pair, that's why this one is more stable. Because of resonance, right?
No conjugation.
Now in this one, hyperconjugation we can talk about, but this one is resonance stabilized also, pi sigma pi. Here we do not have resonance, no conjugation, first one is more stable.
But it's only for alkene, right?
Only for alkene.
That order is only for alkene, not for
all. No, it is overall order. Whatever intermediates we have, carbocation, carbonion, free radical, resonance always dominates hyperconjugation and I effect. This one. For this double bond, we have two sp3 hybridized alpha hydrogen. And for this double bond, we have two sp3 hybridized. But it is sp2.
Yeah.
This is also sp2. For this one, this is also sp2. We won't count this. We require sp3 hybridized alpha hydrogen, not sp2. So 2 plus 2 total 4 alpha hydrogen. For this one, it will be 2 plus 2, 4. Okay. Understood? So now in the molecule, if you have only hyperconjugation possible, then we'll count what? If only hyperconjugation is possible, then we count alpha hydrogen and we can compare separately. What happens if number of alpha hydrogen is same, like in this molecule?
That molecule counts resonance, or you can count induction.
This three. You have to compare the stability of these three molecules. See, when number of alpha hydrogen is same, the number of alpha hydrogen is what? Six. Number of alpha hydrogen? Six. Number of alpha hydrogen? Six. So when the number of alpha hydrogen is same, then what will do you see? The first compound is this.
So what's the difference between the second and the third thing?
This one is cis and this one is trans. Cis trans is, we'll discuss that in isomerism. Okay? So it's a different molecule. Both are different. However, the molecule formula is same. It is also butuene, it is also butuene. But the name of this compound is cis butuene. This is trans butuene. What is cis trans? We'll discuss that in isomerism. Okay? EZ we have, CENTUM we have. We'll discuss that in isomerism. Okay? This molecule is CH2H double bond CH2. Okay.
So why did I do like that? H2C bonded.
You'll understand it. Hyperconjugative structure you have to draw. This sigma bond comes over here, and this pi electron goes onto this carbon. Okay. So we get what? CH2H plus double bond, C single bond, CH2 negative, CH3, correct? Right. It's the same thing. Alpha hydrogen here we have, alpha carbon. Sigma converts into pi, pi converts into sigma, hyperconjugative structure. This C double bond C, alpha carbon, right? It is the same thing. I have written this way. CH3, CH double bond CH. The first example that we have done, in this one, this hydrogen is not there. Instead, we have one more CH3. That is the only difference. Okay? So this H2 and this H, it comes over here and this goes here. Hyperconjugative structure. Okay? First one, look at the example. So you'll get this. Now, this is a carbon ion we are getting, and this is what? 1 degree carbon ion? Yes?
Yeah.
1 degree carbon ion. So we have to compare the stability of this carbon ion in these three molecules. Okay? If you have equal number of alpha hydrogen, then we'll compare the stability of intermediate, which is carbon ion in this case. Okay? Even if you draw the hyperconjugative structure with all other 5 hydrogen, you'll get 1 degree carbon ion only. Is it? With all these 3 plus 2, 5 hydrogen, you'll get this structure only. 1 degree carbon ion. Now, the other one, you see this one, CH2H, CH double bond CH, CH3. So you get here what? This comes over here, and this comes over here. So you'll get CH2H plus double bond CH, single bond CH, negative CH3. There. This is what? This is 2 degree carbon ion. Okay, 2 degree carbon ion. Even for this 2 hydrogen and this 1, 3 hydrogen, again you will get 2 degree carbon ion.
So the higher the degree, the more stable.
For carbon ion, the stability decreases as degree increases.
Yeah, carbocation.
Higher degree, more stable because of plus sign.
Okay.
Okay? Now, so here we are getting 2 degree carbon ion. Here what we get? This one, CH2.
It's less stable.
Okay, again we are getting here 2 degree carbon. So which one is more stable, 2 degree or 1 degree?
1 degree.
1 degree is more stable. So obviously we can say this one is the most rank of this one. This will be first. Second and third we have a confusion, right? Because both gives 2 degree carbon. Now in this what we do, when the methyl group present on the same side, okay? The hindrance is comparatively more here. Trans, when the methyl group are opposite side, the distance is more here. And hence the hindrance is less. Hindrance is less, stability is more, right? So this is first, the trans one is second, and the cis is third. Order of stability will be this. Okay? So basically the number of alpha hydrogen is more, then we'll compare the stability with respect to the stability of the intermediate, which is a carbon ion in case of hyperconjugation in alkene.
How is this more
stable than trans? Cis, generally, if you draw this structure, CH double bond CH, CH3 and CH3, one molecule is this. So this is trans compound because the both methyl group present on the opposite side. Okay? Only one thing you understand here, in the trans, the distance is more between the two methyl group. Cis, what happens, the distance between the methyl group is comparatively less. Both methyl group present on the same side, this way, which is the third molecule. This distance is lesser than this. That's why the repulsion here is less, here the repulsion is more, and hence this one is less stable than this one. Generally, cis alkene is less stable than the trans one. Okay? That's why this is more stable than this. Okay? One thing also we can conclude here, you see this carbon, and this carbon, the double bonded carbon atom. Here the branch on the double bonded carbon atom is 2. Here the branch is what?
1.
Here also it is 1. So when the branch on the double bonded carbon atom increases, the stability of alkene increases due to hyperconjugation. That also we can. More branch here, more. This one is more stable out of the 3. Right? And here the branch on the double bonded carbon atom is 2. So as the branch on the double bonded carbon atom increases, stability of alkene increases due to hyperconjugation, not overall. Stability due to hyperconjugation increases. Okay? So hyperconjugation
is less stable, right?
Which one? The middle one is lesser than, sorry, more than the third one. Okay.
So that branches thing will also work in the other two categories you gave for hydrogen. Like free radicals and catalysts.
For carbocation, it depends. It depends on the molecule. We'll see some examples. But alkene due to hyperconjugation, this one. Always.